we may finally be getting some good news out of Washington. Signs of progress between the White House and Republicans.
Still no agreement on the government shutdown or the debt ceiling, but now both sides are coming up with some ideas to end the standoff. Charlene Israel has the story.
After 11 days, a change of pace.
We had a very useful meeting. It was clarifying, I think, for both sides as to where we are.
The president is happy that cooler heads at least seem to be prevailing in the House, that there at least seems to be a recognition that default is not an option.
In Thursday's meeting, Republicans presented a new plan that would raise the debt ceiling for 6 weeks as talks about a broader budget deal continue. The president neither accepted nor rejected the offer. The White House has been pushing for an extension of at least a year, but now there seems room for negotiation.
Longer is better, but avoiding a crisis is better than having a crisis.
Wall Street surged Thursday after news of progress in Washington. The Dow closed up 323 points, its best day all year.
The situation going on in Washington has put a tremendous amount of pressure on our market, and investors have been waiting for an opportunity to come back into this market. And the information we got today of a short-term resolution clearly is positive news.
Another step forward, the president signed into law a bill providing benefits to the families of fallen troops during the shutdown. The bill passed the House and Senate unanimously. A private group called the Fisher House Foundation had been making payments to the soldiers' families from its own funds before the bill was signed. Pentagon officials plan to reimburse the foundation at the end of the shutdown. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
The government shutdown is also affecting chaplains in the military. John Jessup has that story from our news bureau in Washington. John?
Gordon, Catholic masses could be canceled for a second straight Sunday on about 50 military posts worldwide because some priests have been locked out during the shutdown. The military contracts with civilian priests to fill in at bases that don't have active duty Catholic chaplains. The House voted 400-1 to let the contract chaplains return, but the move was blocked in the Senate by Pennsylvania Democrat Bob Casey. A controversy over Christmas music in October. A Wisconsin school district limited the amount of religiously themed songs to be performed at their Christmas concerts this year because of concerns over endorsing religion. And as Lori Johnson reports, to many parents, that's an off-key decision.
The Wausau, Wisconsin school district informed its music teachers from now on singing about Santa is okay, but Jesus, not so fast. Beginning this December, they must either perform 5 secular songs for every 1 religious one, have a concert with no holiday music at all, or cancel the concert altogether. The school superintendent says public schools shouldn't be endorsing any one religion.
The goal is to make sure that students do not feel coerced into performing songs that make them very uncomfortable.
But the new order seems to be what's making people feel uncomfortable. The high school choir director called off all 15 of the elite Master Singers concerts, saying this group sings at Christmas programs. We sing for nursing homes, grade schools, businesses. To do that without Christmas music doesn't make sense. Many parents agree and are angry about the dissolution of the traditional school Christmas concerts.
Schools should not establish religion, should not promote it, but it should not inhibit it.
Even the school board appears to have been blindsided by the new ban on Christmas songs.
What precipitated this change? Were there complaints? If so, from whom? How many? When did it happen? What kind of documentation do we have for them? It really is that particular question. Why did this have to happen?
The superintendent says backing away from religious music should protect the district from being sued, but didn't mention any lawsuit in particular.
This is all part of the establishment clause. So nothing has to trigger it, really. This is what music in public schools or any teaching in public schools needs to follow.
Lori Johnson, CBN News.
The superintendent says the district did not set a ratio for the number of religious to secular songs. She says that was a misunderstanding. The school board planned a special meeting for last night to deal with the issue. Well, you're about to have even less privacy on Facebook. The website is getting rid of a privacy setting that let members hide their profiles from anyone who wanted to see them. Users will still have the option to block specific people, but now anything you post on Facebook or anything you comment about could turn up in a search. That means it could easily be seen by people you don't know. Gordon, it seems that privacy is more and more a thing of the past.
I would say there's death to privacy in our modern culture. And keep in mind, the government's also watching all of this. The news reported that NSA is supposedly looking at all your social connections, looking at all your networks, particularly if you have anyone who's a friend internationally. They're looking at you and they're keeping a record.
The European Parliament has passed a resolution calling for Iran to release and clear the name of American pastor Saeed Abedini. He's being held in Iran because of charges related to his Christian faith. The resolution had broad support. A widow in Kenya is receiving much needed help from Operation Blessing. Susan was struggling to provide for her children and lacked access to basic necessities like water. Operation Blessing was able to drill a well in Susan's village, providing safe drinking water. Teams also supported the local school by giving nutritious lunches to the children and setting up a community garden and chicken farm project. There, Susan and others can work to earn money to support their families. And you can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to their website at ob.org.